All right, well, folks, we have got TJ Dillashaw stepping in with us. We want you to stay with us, folks. Yes, he's going to sit down with us. But, you know, Dominic, I kind of said during the fight that I was torn between watching TJ fight and watching you watch TJ fight. My friend, there's a lot of intensity. I know you guys are going to make nice here. But, Dominic, you and TJ, I think, have some business to attend to at some point.
I mean, make nice or not, that belt fits me a lot better. I really believe that. But that black guy fits him better than me, too. Oh. So, you know, when we go at it, we're going to go at it. He had a good showing tonight. I'm not going to take anything away from TJ. I've been talking him up this entire night. Nobody's going to deny that. And I think he did his job, and I have to tip my hat. I mean, this isn't something that anybody gets put in this position. Last minute, 24 hours notice, new opponent, deal with it. Here you go. Yeah. He did it.
TJ, congratulations to you. How do you feel after this fight? Are you surprised at all that Joe was able to make it to the fifth round?
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's a tough kid. I landed some good shots on him. You know, I have some things I needed to work on. I came in there a little nervous. It was a crazy situation the last 24 hours. And I got a little more comfortable in the fourth and fifth round. You know, I knew his takedowns weren't going to be there. I defended a couple of them. I took him down. So I knew that my grappling was a little bit more on point. We got a little bit more slippery because we're all sweaty in there. So I felt more comfortable letting loose, throwing more kicks, digging the body, throwing knees when he came in. You know, he was ducking a lot. I tried landing some uppercuts. But just using the angles, and I should have stayed a little bit tighter. You know, I shouldn't have this black eye right now.
TJ, this suit is a disguise, by the way. He's getting intel from you right now.
I got film and you got film. We both got film now.
That's true. I mean, he can learn all the information he wants, but it's when we get in there, it's going to matter. You know,
true.
I mean,
cheers,
I can switch
that
it up on him. So.
Oh, my goodness. I cannot wait. TJ, I do want to ask you about Joe Soto's defense. Yeah. You certainly threw a very high volume of punches and kicks at him tonight. What did you make of his defense?
It was good. You know, he covered well. It ultimately comes down to things I need to work on.
TJ, you know, now that it's all behind us and you've still got that belt, I do want to talk about the emotional element of this game. You know, how frustrated were you today? How were you angry? Were you, you know, sad that it wasn't Hennen, an opponent that you were ready for? I just kind of want to know what your mindset really was now that we know that you kept the belt.
I was really angry last night. You know, it took a lot for me to stay cool. A lot of my interviews, I was pissed off. You know, like during weigh-ins, I was saying he was scared. Who knows what really happened? But, you know, I was just a little angry about the whole situation. You know, I was giving him a favor and giving him a rematch anyways. And for him to do it, bail out on me in an hour notice of the weigh-ins, I was just angry about it. You know, and it was a lot of emotions to deal with.
TJ, you said you want to take a little bit of time off. How much time off? When will we see you next?
I have no idea. You know, it's not really up to me. Mm-hmm. It's all about when they want me to step in the cage. I'll be ready at any time. You know, I'm going to help Mendez train for his fight against Aldo, so I'll be in shape, ready to take a fight. But I'd like to be able to work on some things and fix some holes in my game that I feel like I need to work on a little bit, and just we'll see where it goes from there.